I don't know about you, but I prefer not to have my Amazon packages stolen off my porch. That's why I was so pumped when an associate of mine at work gave me the Ring doorbell. So let's see if it's worth it for you. What's going on, everybody? Jeremy with Detroit Tech. Today, we are talking about smart doorbells to see if the Ring doorbell, this is the version one, is worth the money. This doorbell runs a little under $100 and puts in, really, I'd say kind of the middle of the road price-wise. There are Ring doorbells that are more expensive as well, and the Nest doorbell is definitely up there. Opening up the box was actually kind of fun. It felt like a Russian nesting doll. The stuff just kind of like kept coming out. There are directions to installing the doorbell, something actually really good to have. We'll talk more about that later. The doorbell itself obviously is there, and below it are all the little things you need to really get it up and running. There's an orange micro USB cable, an orange handled screwdriver with both hex and Phillips heads, a masonry drill bit if you have to install it in brick, something like that, and a little level that you can put in to keep it from looking lopsided, a diode to assist with hooking up to a powered doorbell, I didn't need that, and screws and anchors. Setup was pretty simple. Physically, it only took me about 6 minutes or so, even though I started using the anchors in my wood door frame. There's really no excuse. I really like how the actual doorbell connects to the frame. It just really slides on a couple of hooks, and there are a couple screws on the bottom that have hex heads on it that keep it from, you know, just being stolen like that. I mean, if someone really wanted to steal this thing, they could really force it off, but that would at least take a little bit of time and cause a bit of noise. That's where the included screwdriver comes in handy. Phone installation and setup took, I don't know, maybe 10 minutes or so, which included like just kind of putzing around and familiarizing myself with the app. It's basically just the usual follow the directions, scan the QR code, and connect it to your Wi-Fi, and you're good to go. The app provides a lot of functionality. You can click, you know, whichever Ring product you have and take a look there. Once you click on that specific device, there's the battery status, which when clicked will take you into kind of general device settings and health. You can turn your Ring alerts on or off for when someone actually like hits the button on the doorbell. Your motion alert settings live here too. If you, you know, do or don't want alerts pushed to your phone, this is where you set your preferences for that. You can set the snooze time for when you snooze a motion alert. You can, you know, choose the ringtones and all of the general usual stuff, but there are a couple main features that I really want to go over a little bit more carefully. In the video settings, you only have one option, live view on or off. If you turn this on, you can jump into the camera at any time and see what it's seeing live. If you turn it off, you can only see short video recordings when there's like a motion alert. And I'll have some more to say on that later as well. If you have the live view on, your battery is shortened significantly. So I started with this on when I installed that 67% battery out of the box, and it died within about 3 days. So you might really get a week out of it before you had to charge it again. With the live view off, I got 4 weeks to a month or so of battery life. I'd recommend live view off, at least personally. However, if you have like an actual doorbell previously and have the Ring wired to the low voltage power, you won't have to recharge it at all. So I'd recommend at this point really doing whatever you feel like doing. It's your life. The next feature is the motion settings. When you select this, it asks you a couple of questions, like about which of your house faces like a road and then how far away it is. But ultimately the big thing is you get to drag your sensitivity around to get more or less motion alerts. There's a car and a person motion area, like separate. I had to move this very close to the door to not have like 100 alerts a day just from random people walking across the street or cars driving by. So if you're on the smaller lot kind of like mine and don't want to have alerts every time a car drives by, you'll really want to pull this like really, really short of the street. Now that you have those things set, you're ready to send a video of the package thief to the police so they can totally do a lot of work and catch and make him pay. But at 720p resolution, is that really even possible? I mean, yeah, obviously, in a world of 4K security cameras that allow you to like digitally zoom in and get a close-up of someone's face, like 720p sounds just bad. But I mean, really, it's fine. The video is clear and easy enough to see the people that come up to your door. It's super wide angle too. So 180 degrees horizontal and 160 degrees vertical. Honestly, it just won't miss anything. A really cool feature is the neighbors feature. Of course, you can turn it off, but you can look at the different alerts people share. There are videos of people like stealing packages or maps of areas where they have been, like some break-ins recently, or I mean, it's pretty handy if you have a Ring subscription. Yeah, a subscription. So we've gotten to the portion of the video I like to call, you know what really grinds my gears?
You know what really grinds my gears?
So you know what really grinds my gears? When I have to pay for the most basic service after spending a bunch of money on a product. I mean, look, I know they have to keep the servers running and everything, but Wise doesn't have a problem with keeping like their motion clips on their servers for 14 days, and that's without me paying anything. Basically, to do anything other than like have your live view on and then immediately go to that view when you have a motion alert, you have to pay at least $3 a month. If you want to actually be able to see the motion alert video, you have to pay. Want to send an alert to the neighborhood? Yep, gotta pay. I know it's only $3 a month, or $30 if you pay yearly subscription, but really it's just the principle of the thing. Other than that, the biggest issue I had with this thing is the oversensitivity, let's say, of the motion alerts. I've been moving the motion alert area like smaller and smaller and closer to my door, and I think I'm getting close to where it's not too bad. So just kind of be prepared for a lot of alerts if you haven't pushed to your phone. So conclusion time. Would I recommend this doorbell? Yes. I mean, there are some cheaper ones out there, and lots of them have at least a couple of days of free cloud storage to allow you to download and share your videos if need be. I mean, I personally have a little bit of a hard time trusting those basically unknown companies with my information. Though I guess Ring has had its own issues as well. But ultimately, I would rather have a Ring version 1 than those. But also, should you go more expensive? I mean, the other Ring doorbells have a few useful features, 1080p video, interchangeable faceplates, or advanced motion detection, which I still don't know really what that is. But those can get pretty expensive, up to like $500. And also there's the Nest, but their doorbell is literally twice as expensive, and the cloud storage is more expensive at a minimum of $5. But you do have great functionality with your Google devices with that. So if you're willing to pay the extra $3 a month or, you know, $30 a year, I'd say the Ring video doorbell is worth the money if you need or want some extra security. So thanks for watching, everybody. If this review was helpful, hit the thumbs up and subscribe. If you like getting your packages stolen off your porch, I guess you could hit the thumbs down. That's weird. Either way, in the comments below, let me know what smart doorbell you have or will be getting, and we'll catch you in the next one.